off scrolling social media and go to bed. So have an alarm to go to bed and have a fixed time. Second thing, you should have a fixed place to sleep. You should not sleep on the chair or sofa. Okay. You should associate the bed to sleep because body wants sameness. It associates certain things with certain things. Okay. On chair, it associates that you are doing some work. You need to be alert. And when you are in a bed, you should sleep. So have a fixed place for sleep. Now, you have to have a proper environment before you fall asleep. Okay. A few hours leading to your sleep time is very essential. And there should be decrease in the stimulation around yourself as well as your thinking pattern. So you should avoid reading and seeing thrillers, TV film, any entertainment which stimulates you. Avoid stimulants like tea or coffee at least 6 hours before bedtime. We have seen that it has a long half-life. Avoid heavy exercise in the evening, preferably do exercise in the morning. So some people try to do exercise during evening. It's a bad. Okay, try to have exercise in the morning. If you do exercise in the evening, it should be a light exercise. Avoid afternoon nap. Okay, sometimes people take a long afternoon nap and they take at a later part of a day. So if you have to take a nap, you should take at 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock. Okay, and for only say 15, 20 minutes. If you sleep for 1 or 2 hours in the afternoon, then it would be difficult to fall asleep in the night. Then there has to be ritual as far as sleep is concerned. Okay, so you should relax before you sleep. Then you should have some shower. You should take some light walk, or you should do some gentle exercise, or maybe you should listen to some soothing music before you sleep. Let the light in your home be dim 1 hour before sleep. Let the atmosphere be like that. Go to bed when you are asleep. Don't go to the bed and just try to force sleep. Then how should be your bedroom? Okay, so your bedroom should be dark. If there is any light, it will hamper your sleep. Temperature is very important. It is essential that you should have some cold temperature. If it is very hot, it would disturb sleep. So slightly cold temperature help for sleep. You should keep your window open so that the fresh air is circulated. Okay, there should not be noise in your room. Then once you go to bed, then first of all, you should pray to your God. Second thing, if good thing has occurred over a day, you should express your gratitude to a God for the good things. If you have done some wrong things, then you should ask for forgiveness. If somebody has done wrong, then you should forgive them. Okay. Then you should go to bed and just slowly close your eyes. And then you have to just observe your breath. Okay. So observe the breath coming in, coming out at the nostril. Then your mind is like a monkey. It will have one thought, other thought. A lot of chatters will occur in your mind. And this chatter is responsible for sleep deprivation, difficulty in falling asleep. So if you have any thought, you have to bring back your attention at nostril. And this is also called as mindful meditation. Okay. So observe your breath. Breathe very slowly. Observe your breath at nostril, air coming in, air going out. And if you fall asleep in this way, your sleep also become mindful meditation. Okay. You can do progressive muscle relaxation in the bed. So if you go to bed, then contract your muscle for 5 seconds, then relax it for 5 seconds and keep it there in a relaxed state for 15 to 20 seconds. Okay. So this cycle, you should start from toes, then leg, thigh, abdomen, chest, hand, neck, face. Okay. So contraction, relaxation, and remain in relaxed state for 15 seconds. And when whole body is relaxed, then just observe your breath at nostril Okay. And if you have any thoughts in your mind, bring back your attention at nostril. So in this way, if you do, you will fall asleep within few minutes. Okay. Don't force yourself asleep. Go to sleep. Just let the sleep occur naturally. And during that time, just observe your breath at nostril. And if you do it, if you do this mindful meditation while sleeping, I'll assure you, whatever may be the problem, you will fall asleep. Sometimes it may be difficult to fall asleep. You go to bed, then you're just dozing from right, left side, but you are not having sleep. Then what you should do? So Dale Carnegie said, if you can't sleep, then get up, do something instead of lying there and worrying. It's worry that gets you, not the lack of sleep. Okay. So if you are unable to fall asleep, get up, do some mental and physical activity and return to the bed again when you are sleepy. Okay. And stop inner chatter. So dear friends, in this 50 minutes, we have shared that sleep is very essential for our health. If you are chronically sleep deprived, you are more prone for various psychological and physical disorders. If you sleep 7 to 9 hours of uninterrupted sleep, you will lead a very healthy life. Okay. So I will discuss certain tips so that it will help you to fall asleep and have sound uninterrupted sleep. Thank you so much.
Sir, thank you. Thank you very much. I would like to start summarizing it with you. The middle word you have said, pray before sleeping. Say,
absolutely.
Pray before sleeping, because according to our religion, there are some certain verses to pray before sleeping. If I would like to translate it, it becomes like this. Oh Allah, oh my God, I am going to sleep with your name. I will be wake up again with your name. So it is praying.
Absolutely.
And just if anybody want to sleep, then if he can follow your instruction that you have said, that please get rid of your worries, get rid of your tensions, and please try to relax your muscles first, then follow your breathing, then obviously he can sleep. You have also pointed out that sleep needs an environment. The room should be dark, the room should be cool, and while you have to go at a certain time, and please use bed, not chair or sofa, anything else for sleeping. So it is a natural phenomena. It will be occurred if we follow the instruction properly, and sound sleep, as our Dr. Sunil Sable was mentioning, that sound sleep is essential for well or healthy body, healthy mind.
Absolutely.
Because sleep Absolutely. Has impact not only in physical body, but also in mental health. So if we require a fitness in our physical body, as well as fitness in mental condition, then we should have sleeping at least 7 to 9 hours for elder people and more for the children. So with these few words, Dr. Sunil Sable, I would like to offer our sincere thanks for joining us today. And hopefully in future, we'll talk again, maybe on another topic. And please consider developing Bangladesh is also a part of your noble mission. You would like to inspire 2 million people. 2 million people.
Absolutely.
So we are your partner in this noble mission. Thank you once again, sir.
Thank you so much.